لله رب العالمين حمدا طيبا كثيرا مباركا ملأه من السماوات والأرض. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيه ورسوله. سئل أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال من أسعد الناس بشفاعتك يوم القيامة؟ قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أسعد الناس بشفاعتي يوم القيامة من قال لا إله إلا الله خالصة بها نفسه. أبو هريرة asked the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم who's going to be the most glad person by your intercession in the day of judgment? So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied to his question, the most glad person by my intercession in the day of judgment, the person who will say la ilaha illallah by a very sincere heart. Wa nashhadu anna sayyidina Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam abduhu wa rasuluhu. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اجعل تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مرحوما. اللهم اجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. اللهم انصر أمة الإسلام في كل مكان تحت كل أرض وسماء. Dear brothers and sisters, Ramadan Mubarak for everyone. I know this is the second Jum'ah, but I want to say again, Ramadan Mubarak and Jum'ah Mubarak. Just imagine a blessed day, which is a Jum'ah, and a blessed month. So we have two blessings today, our Jum'ah and our month. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us like in this month and in that day. Our khutbah slogan today, let's show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our goodness during this month. Let's show our goodness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Waqi'ah categorized the people to three kinds. As-sabiqun, أصحاب اليمين and أصحاب الشمال. And السابقون, those people who will enter the Jannah before anyone, without a punishment, without any struggle. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, والسابقون السابقون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeated the word السابقون, those people who will enter the Jannah twice. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeat that word, it means there is something very important. So as-sabiqun, as-sabiqun. Then let's see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will describe them. Ulaika al-muqarrabun. Those people will be very close to us in the day of judgment. Just imagine in our dunya, when I want to be proud of something, I'm gonna say I'm very close to that congressman. I know a businessman, right? But imagine in the day of judgment, you're gonna be very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you from any harm that day. So let's continue and see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying about as-sabiqun. في جنات النعيم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the sabiqoon to his gardens to enjoy our time, our mortal time. We're going to be mortal in the inshallah in the day of judgment. So there is no harm, there is peace, only peace. في جنات النعيم ثلة من الأولين وقليل من الآخرين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying about those who are going to be as-sabiqoon, a huge group from the first generations of Islam. ثُلَّةٌ مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ It means, let's talk about what did the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ describe those groups. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the best generation is one generation and the next generation. التابعي وتابعي التابعي. So ثُلَّةٌ مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ The best group of people who are الصحابة, التابعي and تابعي التابعي. وَقَلِيلٌ مِنَ الْآخِرِينَ And a few group of us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us who are attending this masjid and anyone listening to this khutbah and all the Muslimin to be a part of this group. Say Ameen. And the second category, the second kind of people, Ashab al-Yameen. Those might struggle in the day of judgment. They might get a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But let's see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them. وَأَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينِ مَا أَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about them. Mentioned them twice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will list them with a lower level in Jannah al-Firdaus. And also they're going to be in Jannah al-Firdaus. But in a lower level than as-sabiqoon. And ashab al-shimal, they're going to be the third kind of people. But inshallah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to prevent all of us to be among them. Say ameen. So, as I mentioned in the beginning, our slogan today, let's show our goodness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today is the 10th day of Ramadan. So we have only 20 or maybe 19 days till the end of that month. So 10 days have been passed. Some of us spend some effort to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in an amazing way. Some of us, they prepared themselves in the month of Sha'ban to come here at the month of Ramadan to be very well prepared. To read the Quran, to do the Siyam, but some of us are not. So today we're going to talk about some action items. If some of us didn't prepare ourselves before Ramadan and we didn't do well at the beginning of the 10 days, so let's inshallah try to be good in the remaining 20 days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed the month by revealing the Quran during the month of Ramadan in the night of Qadr. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed the night, the night of Al-Qadr by the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah in ayah number 185 and said about that month. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن الله سبحانه وتعالى revealed the Quran in that month هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان Why did Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed the Quran in this month? As a guidance for people, as a mercy for people. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى made that month, month of guidance and month of mercy. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he comes to Ramadan, he will be like his thawb and he will say, inshallah, I'm gonna do the best ibadah during that month. Brothers and sisters, as I mentioned, some of us prepare themselves very well before Ramadan, and some of us are not. Some of us did well, alhamdulillah, in the first 10 days of Ramadan, and some of us did not. So let's together share some action items to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this month and the remaining 20 days of Ramadan. As we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will release some people, a number of people, every single night in Ramadan from the hellfire. This according to the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So let's ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among those who will be released from the hellfire tonight. And if it's not tonight, so inshallah in the remaining night of Ramadan. So our first action item, reading the Quran, but not only reading the Quran, but we should get along with the Quran. Some of us have said, I want to do the Khatm al-Quran during the 30 days of Ramadan. Right, I agree, that's amazing. It's a lot of hasanat. But let's like, think about it. I'm reading the Quran. But first of all, I have to understand that I should get along with my readings. I should get along with my reciting. I should understand what Allah, the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the Quran. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab didn't memorize the Quran just like in a year or like 2 years. No, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab memorized the Quran in several years. But what the difference between Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab memorization and our own memorization? What the difference? The difference, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab used to understand every single ayah, and not only that, he used to apply in his life. When he hear or when he learn a new ayah about the siyam, so Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab will make sure he will do the best siyam in his life. When he hear in the Quran any ayah, any verses talking about the manners of Islam, so Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab will apply this manner in his life before he memorized the ayah. So Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab used to memorize by actions, not only by reading, not only by just like, you know, reciting the Quran. So I'm going to give you the first action item tonight, today, and please try to apply before you sleep and during like, if you are going to drive, if you are going like, you know, hanging out with your friends, you can do this ayah. Like it's very, very small ayahs you can recite. First of all, I'm going to talk about Surah Tabarak, Surah Al-Mulk. Surah Al-Mulk, all of us know, we know how to read it. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. This amazing surah. Try to take from your time 10 minutes or 15 minutes before you sleep to recite it. So what the benefit from reciting Surah Al-Mulk before you sleep? According to the authentic hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when I recite Surah Al-Mulk before I sleep, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect me from the punishment in our graves. Or, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us from the punishment in the grave. It's only 10 or 15 minutes before you sleep. Just read it. It's not going to take a long time from you. And try to be away from your phone, try to be away from your tablet, and just like, feel the sakina. Try to be calm before you sleep. For sure, it's going to help you to sleep. Feel the peaceful of this ayat. The second thing with the Quran, according to the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you read Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times, it's equal memorizing the Quran or equal reciting the whole Quran. How long it takes to read Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times? I want to try it right here. Let's revive the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and let's find out how long it takes to read Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times. Right? Can you please like, repeat with me, inshallah, Surah Al-Ikhlas? Bismillah ar-rahman ar-raheem. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. How long did it take? 3 minutes? 4 minutes? So just imagine when you read Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times in any time in your day, just like 4 or 5 minutes, right? It equal that he did the khalq of Quran. What a blessing. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving tips for us how to do khatm al-Qur'an in 5 minutes. And some of us refuse to do that. So let's say, inshallah, I will do that today. Say inshallah. Inshallah. So the first action item, reading the Qur'an. But not only reading the Qur'an and get along with it. The second action item, to be among as-sabiqoon. To be among as-sabiqoon. To be among the best people who will do the best effort to the dhikr, to do the ibadah during the month of Ramadan. During the month of Ramadan. The second action item, al-istighfar. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do istighfar 100 times every day. But not the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he do the istighfar, he's not saying astaghfirullah one time. No. The Prophet will say istighfar as much as he can, then he will repeat it 100 times. So there is an amazing hadith for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is that Sayyidul Istighfar. When you do istighfar, you should recite that dhikr. Let's say it together. La ilaha illa ant, Rabbi khalaqtani wa ana abiduk. وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. This hadith, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم called it سيد الاستغفار, the master of استغفار. When you said the hadith, if you die in your night, if you die in the morning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you to the Jannah. All of us know Adhkar al-Sabah and Adhkar al-Masa, right? This is one of the most important ahadith for Adhkar al-Sabah and Adhkar al-Masa. Let's hear another hadith for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you will say the hadith 100 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins in your life. Not only one sin, not only two sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins. Astaghfirullah al-azim alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum wa atubu ilayh. If you say astaghfirullah al-azim alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum 100 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins. So please try to take from your time tonight, inshallah, start tonight to do istighfar 100 times as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. The last action item, my third action item, we're going to do the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an authentic hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A Bedouin man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked the Prophet, can you teach me how to do dhikr? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, say, Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. So the man began to count on his hand, Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. So what the benefit when I say that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will plan for you a palm tree in the Jannah. This, the benefit from that dhikr, when I say Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will plant for me a palm tree in Jannah. But a palm tree in Jannah is not like our palm tree for sure. Try to imagine how it looks like. Just try to imagine. So the Bedouin man, when he started to leave the matter of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he is repeating that dhikr, suddenly he stopped. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he will turn back to me. That poor man, that kind man, remember something, and he gonna come and ask me. So he went and asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, thank you for teaching me this like dhikr, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. And this is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what it remain for me? What is for me? So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, after he said subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa Allahu Akbar, you should say Allahumma ighfir li, Allahumma arhamni, Allahumma arzuqni. Allahumma ighfir li, Allahumma arhamni, Allahumma razuqni. Then the Bedouin man began to count 8 dhikr on his hand while he's leaving. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, Allahumma ighfirli, Allahumma arhamni, Allahumma razuqni. I forget to tell you something. When I talked about like reciting Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you also with a palace in Jannah. Just imagine yourself how much the effort you are spending to buy a house in our dunya. How much the effort are you spending to pay your mortgage? How much effort are you spending to pay your down payment for that, for your house? But here we are talking about in palace, in Jannah, in our mortal life, in Jannah, inshallah. So, when you recite Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times, do the dhikr, Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, because you are doing your garden around your palaces in Jannah. Please, brother and sister, I need and I want everyone to imagine your palace in Jannah and your garden in Jannah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. لا إله إلا أنت ربي سبحانك خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. Brothers and sisters, today I came representing Islamic belief. We have our own table, our Sayyid. InshaAllah, you're going to find our sister with a niqab, inshaAllah, helping everyone who wants to donate for our Islamic cause around the world. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day has been asked, what the best month for fasting after the month of Ramadan? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered, it's the month of Sha'ban. And then the Sahaba asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the best sadaqah? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best sadaqah is the sadaqah during the Ramadan. Try to imagine that. When you give a sadaqah right now, it's gonna be considered the best sadaqah you're gonna give. Alhamdulillah, Islamic League has many causes around the world. We have a lot of crises around the world. We have Palestine. We have Gaza. We have Myanmar. We have Bangladesh. We have Pakistan. We have Afghanistan. We have a lot of crises. Islamic Relief is providing right now help for all these people. So I ask every one of you who came today to offer Salatul Jum'ah in that blessed month, to donate to Islamic Relief. Alhamdulillah, we have a lot of projects. So you're gonna find a lot of brochures outside. They're gonna tell you about our own projects. Alhamdulillah, Islamic Relief is the best relief organization working with our brothers and sisters in Myanmar. You know that in Myanmar, most of our Muslim brothers and sisters, they left the country and now they are on the borders of Bangladesh. And wallahi, they are suffering. If you see the camps where they live right now, wallahi, it's a crisis. So alhamdulillah, Islamic Relief and other relief organizations, they are trying to help our Muslims and brothers. But I want to say that alhamdulillah, Islamic Relief is the biggest organization who offers help for our brothers and sisters in Myanmar. Inshallah, I'm going to do the dua, and please make ta'meena for me. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا اللهم اجعل هذا تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مرحوما ومن بعده تفرقنا تفرقا معصوما اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار اللهم انصر إخواننا المسلمين والمستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين اللهم انصر إخواننا في سوريا اللهم انصر إخواننا في العراق اللهم انصر إخواننا في مصر اللهم انصر إخواننا في بنغلاديش اللهم انصر إخواننا في أفغانستان اللهم انصر إخواننا في ميانمار وصل اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أقول قولي هذا وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله بحق.